Well, 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 welcome to the Action Zone. It's that time of the year when the glitter and sparkle of exquisite jewelry lights up your world. Yes, you guessed it right. It's the final jewelry round of the 4th GJF National Jewelry Awards. It is the premier organization of the gems and jewelry industry in India and includes all industry segments, the manufacturers, wholesalers, and the retailers across India. And what a day it's going to be as jewelers from across the country have sent in some truly beautiful pieces of art and craftsmanship, which will be judged in various categories. To ensure that the judging is fair and unbiased, we have a process validation partner, RSM Astute Consulting Group. These have all been evaluated by a special jury. Talking about the jury, we have the most accomplished and experienced panel from the industry and the media. Let's meet them.
Dr. Usha Balakrishnan. She is the only historian of Indian jewelry among the very few jewelry historians in the world. She lectures and writes on the history of art and jewelry. Rupa Vora, India's only revivalist couture jeweler. She is credited with almost single-handedly reviving the age-old craft of Thewa jewelry. She is also a master of the innovative concept of Nakashi. Sangeeta Singh. She is featured in the prestigious Marquee's Who's Who in the World 2014 directory. Was conferred the award for Outstanding Business Communicator 2014. Aarti Surendranath. A producer with over 25 years experience. She is chief producer, creative consultant, stylist, production designer, and member of the board of directors of the renowned Kailash Picture Company. Beena Aziz, an artist, curator, philanthropist, and entrepreneur. She has taken Indian art and artists across the globe. Shefali Patel, a renowned lecturer in jewelry design. She is also consultant to numerous companies and manufactures customized handmade jewelry for private clients in the USA, Africa, and New Zealand.
Our judges are hard at work inside. They cannot be disturbed. But if you promise to be very, I'll take you in for a wee bit.
I think the first impression is one of great pride because India is all about hand craftsmanship, and it's such a feeling of pride to see that the craftsmen are still there and hand craftsmanship is still alive, and we are the only country in the world that is still producing such high quality handcrafted jewelry.
Most of the pieces that I have seen are absolutely fantastic. You get to see the craftsmanship and you get to see the skill and the talent that people have. This is my first time here and I'm completely floored by the designs and the innovation that the people have shown in their designs. Very, very, very good jewelry.
I'm seeing there's a distinct improvement in terms of design. There's a distinct improvement in terms of craftsmanship. People are innovating a lot more. You can distinctly tell whether it's a person from a small town or it's somebody from a metro, because the sensibilities are varied. But in this time, I'm feeling that there is a merge of sensibilities. So I do feel that that design sensibility is now permeating into the smaller cities, the mini metros, so to speak.
Most of these pieces are really stunning. And for me, a jewelry has to make a statement. So when I see something and you instantly know, okay, this is something that one would want to pick up or want to own. But on the whole, it's been a little difficult judging, I must say, but very impressed with all the jewelry that I've seen this afternoon, definitely.
It's wonderful to see that that old style is still there. A little bit, a lot of it is mixed and made into a bit of a fusion. But it's wonderful to see that there are still some of the old designs, and the jewelry is all individually from India. It is not things imbibed from anywhere else in the world. So it was a pleasure to watch that.
This year round, compared to last year, there are many more creative and innovative designs. So it was so refreshing to see a lot of jewelers participate. So in fact, congratulations GJF on reaching out to the industry and making sure everybody participates. So, well, keep up the efforts and hoping that it gets better every year and gives a chance to a lot more manufacturers, retailers and wholesalers and who are members and non-members participating in, at such a big platform.
For me, everything starts and ends at craftsmanship. So I think that's what I watch for, having worked with crafts for the last so many years. That's all I look for. And yes, there is innovation, but craftsmanship is something that stands out the most.
We are seeing pieces where all those three aspects are coming together more and more. And of course, hand craftsmanship reigns supreme. India is the greatest handcrafting tradition in the world. And we also see the fact that in the Indian jewelry area, the designer and the craftsman often come together. The designer is the craftsman is the designer, and you see that fusion happening in all the jewels that are on exhibition today.
I see a lot of patterns, a lot of Italian styles, a lot of making from different countries. Some of the invisible setting is from the Far East. All kinds of making comes together.
This year, you could see that creativity has reached its new level. And it's nice to see the jewelers are encouraging new designers. In fact, there's a new category which was introduced by the GJF, which is for aspiring new jewelry designers. So it's given them opportunity to send in their designs, and I'm waiting to see that. And thank you again, GJF, for introducing new designers and giving them a platform to, straight away get into our industry.
The creativity and innovation and the craftsmanship, absolutely, hands on.
All the categories impressed me because they were all by the paramparik and the master craftsmen of Indian jewelry. So it would be very, very difficult for me to identify one single category. I think each and every one of the categories has brought out the best in craftsmanship, the best in design, the best in our heritage, the ability of the craftsman to handle material, to handle metal, to handle his sensitivity to design. So I think long live the Indian paramparik karigar. Each and every one of these was a paramparik karigar.
I think without a doubt, and you're going to get the same answer throughout today, is the paramparik category. It's interesting and heartening to see that crafts of India are taking center stage.
I think the paramparik jewelry was the most unique, and it had some outstanding designs.
The paramparik, of course, every piece was unique, and the way it was handcrafted and the designs were so outstanding.
And I just like many individual pieces from each collection. I've tried to think to answer in all sincerity, but there are just specific pieces.
The most interesting category was the unique jewelry. It was very interesting and exciting to see jewelers use different techniques and manufacturing different processes were used in making the jewelry pieces. So definitely the unique jewelry was the most interesting category that I've seen today.
GJF Avi, both उसका जो विस्तार है वो बहुत बढ़ रहा है पैन इंडिया हो रही है इस टाइम मुझे बहुत खुशी हुई और मैं बताना चाहता हूँ कि इस टाइम लास्ट ईयर से 3 गुना ज़्यादा एंट्रीज आई हुई है और वो भी पैन इंडिया से हम पैन इंडिया तक जाने में कामयाब हो गए बेसिकली हम चाहते थे कि ईस्ट वेस्ट नॉर्थ साउथ सभी जगह से लोगों को इसमें इन्वॉल्व करना है इंडस्ट्री को जोड़ना है और उसमें हम बहुत हद तक कामयाब हो गया लेकिन हमें और भी रिमोट एरिया में भी जाना है और हम इसके आगे भी जाएंगे इस 2014 में एनजीए में हमने 2 नए चीज़ लाई हैं एक है स्टूडेंट कैटेगरी जो इस इंडस्ट्री से जुड़ना चाहता है जो इस इंडस्ट्री के इंजन जो डिज़ाइनर स्कूल में काम करता है या एडमिशन लेता है उसको हम स्पॉन्सर कर रहे हैं, उनको स्कॉलरशिप दे रहे हैं फर्दर स्टडी के लिए। तो उनके लिए एक हमने कैटेगरी की है कि जिसमें टैलेंट है उन लोगों को ये कंपटीशन में हमने इन्वॉल्व किया है। ऑल ओवर इंडिया से सभी इंस्टीट्यूट इसको जुड़ी हुई है और इसमें ट्रिमेंडस लोगों में जोश है और उन्होंने बहुत काफ़ी हद तक इसमें भाग लिया है ऑल इंडिया से। और उसमें हमने एक स्टूडेंट को 1.5 लाख, ऐसे 10 स्टूडेंट को प्रमोट करने का इस टाइम हमने योजना बनाई है और वो हम कर रहे हैं। दूसरा भाग है पारंपरिक ज्वेलरी। पारंपरिक ज्वेलरी मतलब जो नॉन मेंबर्स के लिए, जीजीएफ के मेंबर्स के साथ साथ सभी इंडस्ट्री के लोगों को जोड़ने के लिए हमने पारंपरिक ज्वेलरी कैटेगरी निर्माण की है, जिससे कि कारीगर हो, बाबू हो, हर एक एरिया के लोगों को जोड़ने का हमने कोशिश की है। और मुझे बहुत खुशी होती है जो हमने स्टेप लिया है, इतने अप्रिशिएट किए हैं जूरी ने, जजेस ने, कि सभी कैटेगरी में पारंपरिक ज्वेलरी को सबने बहुत अच्छी तरह से उनको एंजॉय किया, उन्होंने बहुत उसकी तारीफ की और मुझे इसमें बहुत बहुत खुशी मिलती है। हम चाहते हैं इस इंडस्ट्री को समझना चाहिए, इतना टैलेंट है, हिडन टैलेंट है इंडिया में जो हम बाहर लाना चाहते हैं, जो चाहते हैं कि उसको एक प्लेटफॉर्म मिले। और हम चाहते हैं कि सभी लोग, भले और हमको जाना पड़े, हर एक गांव में, हर एक स्टेट में हमें जाके लोगों को बताना है कि इंडिया इज़ अ वेरी गुड टैलेंट। इंडिया में बहुत अच्छे क्राफ्ट्समैनशिप है, बहुत अच्छे वर्कमैन है, बहुत अच्छे डिज़ाइनर है, इतनी अच्छी अच्छी आइडिया है। ये इंटरनेशनल लेवल लेके जाने के लिए, लोगों तक लाने के लिए, इस इंडस्ट्री को आगे बढ़ाने के लिए हम ये करना चाहते हैं। और मैं चाहता हूँ ये सबको इस माध्यम से देखने को मिलेगा कि इंडिया में बहुत अच्छे अच्छे वर्कर है, कारागिर है, डिज़ाइनर है, और उसका सम्मान करने के लिए ये नेशनल ज्वेलरी अवार्ड हमने बनाया।
With that, we come to the end of the jury round of the 4th GJF National Jury Awards 2014. The action now shifts on to the glittering awards night on the 21st of Feb 2014. Till then, keep smiling.